Hello, beautiful people and family of light. Hello, everyone. My name is Eliza Mozal. I am an energy healer and a spiritual mentor. And I wanted to talk about something that I often think the things are so obvious to everyone because I've spoke about them a lot, or they made a huge big change and shift on my own journey. And I forget that there's so many things that we have to talk about over and over again. Every time it's in a different way, but the number one key to fundamental healing, it is only one. It is opening your heart energy center, which is in the middle of your chest. You can feel it as your own chest as well, whichever side you have. I actually met once a person who had a heart in the other side of the chest. That's how he was born. And yes, you can have it on both sides. I don't know why am I talking about it, but here it is. Why do I talk about it? Because I notice people, I help people heal. I'm one of the best things that I can do as an energy healer is to help someone open their heart, and it happens really fast. And I remember without having anyone's help, quite some time ago, it took me really long time to do it on my own. It took me really long time to do it on my own. And I kind of had a little bit help there, but it took me a while. And that's good as well, because it enriched my experience with all the stuff that doesn't work and things that works the most that has to be taken care of first. And I have been observing lots of people who are having that opportunity to open their heart, and it feels too scary. It feels too scary because it's unfamiliar, because it isn't something that we do all the time. And you know, when we got hurt in any shape and form, and usually that's on an emotional level, when we are children, we close our hearts. We're learning from adults who have their hearts closed as well how to do it, how to say no, how to use all those different excuses, justifications, reasons, price tags, sizes, everything to say no, right? And I've done it myself for most of my life. And I couldn't figure out how come I'm spinning in circles. It's loud over there. I've changed the location, so I'm no longer in Europe. At the moment, I am in different part of the world, and it is loud over here, and it's gorgeous and it's beautiful. And I am more than grateful. I'm more than grateful and very appreciative. So going back to exactly these things happen and only start with opening our hearts. And for me, it was huge to start working with Dr. Joe Dispenza teachings. And before I was doing that, I was working 12-step program that helped me a lot, helped me tremendously. And then I dove into other spiritual practices because I felt like there is more for me there. There is more for me to do. There is deeper stuff for me to see and bring it up to the surface, or just simply allow myself to stay aware and present enough so it comes up to the surface on its own, because that's what is the nature of the energy. As long as we don't push it, force it, reject it or resist it, we don't push it down. And that's where the most energy is going. The most energy that we are wasting / using, if you really wanna be kind and compassionate. And you should. Oh, no shoulds and shouldn'ts. What am I saying? It's good. It's all good. It's all good. Most of the energy that we are wasting is going for resistance patterns. Resistance, rejecting what we think and feel. It's too scary or too ugly to see. And the truth is that every single one of us are the beings of light. We are of light. We are divine. We are divine incarnate in these bodies, in these shapes, in these forms. We come from the same stuff as the stars. We are literally gods ourselves. Different meaning, different understanding. That name was butchered for too long, through thousands of years. But you are your own source. You are the creator. You are creating your own life, you know? I remember times when my body was much bigger, when my face wasn't There was no not much smile on my face. I was dying my hair dark, black, like black for like 15 years. And you know, on the outside, I was an expression of what was going on inside: resistance, pain, illness, not feeling good about myself at all, depression, anxiety, resentment. Inability to forgive and let go in any shape and form. Inability to look at people in a new way, with a new light. And I'm really, really grateful that's not the case. But it all started with opening my heart and daily dedication. And then it came bigger understanding. Okay, I'm opening my heart. I'm doing all of these things. I'm putting so much work and energy into it. And yet, every January, February, depression comes back, like a little bit, more or less, but still I'm not happy about that. And I feel puzzled and I reject myself again, right? And then I would be doing all of that stuff and I would be feeling so judgmental towards other people. And I would be like, why? I don't want to be this way. I don't want to be this way. That's not true me. That's not true me, what's going on. And I had to just simply go deeper. And I started learning more about energy. And I started learning that every single thought that floats somewhere around me, it isn't actually mine. It doesn't have to be even mine unless I choose to take it consciously or unconsciously and make it mine or mistake it by mine. Muji talks about how some people are constantly in reaction, never response, in reaction mode to every single thought they are experiencing, believing, fully being convinced this is who they are. And I've been there myself, unable to detach and understand that I am not my thoughts, I am not my feelings, I am not my emotions, I am not that pain, I am not that old feeling, I am not failure, all of that stuff. And I started learning and expanding, but all of that came with the biggest accumulation when I started opening my heart. And that's when I started understanding I don't even feel worthy of being healed. I don't even feel worthy to live the life of my dreams. I don't even feel good enough to look good enough for my own eyes, for my own heart. So it was a process. It was a process. And I'm so grateful for everything that happened and in my own divine pace and timing. The way I work with clients right now, that within a week or two we fully blast open that heart, and it's just amazing. It's just amazing. But without open heart, we always will be feeling incomplete, and we will always. They're really loud over here. We always, and I love it. I love it. By the way, you always feel connected. So, with that open heart, you will always be feeling wholeness. You will always be feeling greater level of consciousness. And if you don't, you go back straight to, you open up and straight away you're raising your frequency and vibration, and you are it. You are that love. You are that frequency of light. You are that frequency of joy and peace and bliss. When that heart is closed, you're not whole. You're torn apart. You're blocked from your own divinity. You're blocked from your wholeness. So it's normal and natural. You will be tearing apart others. You, your own mind will be in your own head telling you that that person you love the most, there's something wrong with them. That's just the way energy works. The specific thoughts, emotions and feelings are belonging to specific vibration. So the lowest vibration is guilt and shame. And when you feel guilt and shame, this is where you are. This is where your frequency. But when you raise your frequency and you are on the frequency of acceptance, right? You're just okay with it. It doesn't bother you, it doesn't tear you apart any longer. Then you are able to choose to go down or go up or stay where you are, which is just beautiful as well. And any choice is just another choice we are making. Opening our hearts, I seen with my own eyes, I felt with my own heart, what is it doing to people? It's magnificent. It is extraordinary from life and living in constant fear, watching over your shoulder, being scared and afraid of something, someone coming and getting you, you know? Being afraid that you're gonna be fired from work because you forgot to file this one paper, whatever it is. Living in that fear, insecurity, not good enoughness, with that depression and anxiety on the back, on your back, constantly something, someone unhappy with you, or you being unable to stop obsessing about something and someone, fear, germs, lack, right? All of that stuff is on the lower frequency. When you open your heart and you raise your frequency, forgiveness comes automatically. You just love. You cannot not love. You just love. Literally, you just are love. That resentment that you had towards your mother for not being your mother, especially when you needed a mother, it just falls off. You just feel compassion. You just feel love, compassion. You want to give compassion. And that's what you do. That's what you do. You go and you give that love and compassion to that person. If there is someone you want to get in touch with, you feel compassion, forgiveness. You're just not interested in being around them. That's it. With full on love, compassion, forgiveness, with full on freedom. When we open our hearts, everything is changing. And it's not only you that is affected. Your whole life and family will be affected. My clients are sending me messages telling, Eliza, after our healing session, my distant sister called me. We didn't spoke for a very, very, very long time. She called me out of nowhere, you know, and we had a really nice, decent conversation. And she's been working on opening her heart. She opened her heart for a few weeks by this time. So magnificent things are happening. People I worked with, they all of a sudden start seeing beautiful opportunities for their life. They go to work and they feel this love attacks. They don't feel panic attacks any longer. They feel love attacks. The person I'm working with, she sends me a message and tells me that, Eliza, all I wanted to do is just to love them. And I kept on sending them love. It's just magnificent to be able to shift the energy, to be able to reset the button. And trauma gets healed like that. And this is phenomenal for me, because I myself carried trauma for many years. And it really had such a strong hook on me. I had no idea. Is that ever gonna be resolved? And with this energy work, everything is possible. But it is as well our daily commitment to ourselves, our hearts. It is our daily attitude. It is our daily thoughts, emotions, and actions. We choose to pay attention. We choose to make, do, be. If you are opening your heart and then you are deciding, you know what, I'm just gonna go and do some of that old stuff, don't expect that the good stuff we're gonna keep on flowing. Maybe for a little bit, but then the channel will be cut off. At least that's my experience. And I'm not saying that from a place of fear. I paid the price many times, and this is how I learned as well. And they are many times when I'm missing the mark. I'm literally... I spent 30, 36 hours on a plane, trains, and all of that. And you know what? I've just simply done my best. I've done my best and I've done well. And that's okay. That's fine. Letting go of perfectionism, it's another huge, big deal when we open our hearts. And another huge thing happens as well when we open our hearts. We allow ourselves to be humans and spiritual beings in the same time. So it is no longer about just those top chakras, that they are all about empathy, feeling energy, all of that. We are all about being human as well, receiving and giving, cleaning, cleansing, processing all of it as a wholeness. And I'll be talking about it in the next video. I'm gonna send lots and lots and lots of love to every single one of you. And now, if opening your heart is something that is a struggle for you, it was for me. It was for me, like, not even come close. I'm not even talking to you. I was unable to trust even a person 6 years ago, 7 years ago. No way. And it's not like that today. If you feel like your heart is blocked, you don't even know what love feels like, you just need help. You just need help. That's it. That's it. Allow yourself to receive help, and the right person will be placed on your path. And then allow yourself to ask for that help and receive the yes. And if the person is going to say no, go somewhere else and don't stop until you will get the yes. Because if you have desire for it, it's already there for you. It is already there for you. And there is no better life than with an open heart. And if it gets closed, okay, that's fine. Let's go back into having that heart open, fully open. 10, 15 minutes, here we go, back again. Even if it takes a day, so be it. Still worth it. I'm sending you lots of love. Bye-bye.